heart of the entertainment world. The Hollywood Palace. It's your host, Roy Armstrong. Tonight, Ballet Folklorico of Mexico, Diahann Carroll, the Folklorico's exciting deer dance, Jimmy Durante, Rowan and Martin, Edward G. Robinson, Mitchell Ayers of the Hollywood Palace Orchestra, all brought to you by Manpower, the power-packed aerosol deodorant by the makers of Old Spice, Manpower, and by Max Factor, creators of Hi-Fi Fluid, the moisturized liquid makeup that gives your complexion a new dewy beauty. We'll return to the Hollywood Palace after a word from one of our sponsors.
This is what a moisturized makeup can do for you. Hi-Fi Fluid by Max Factor. The moisturized makeup that gives your skin a new dewy beauty. Only Hi-Fi with its four separate moisturizers could give your skin such a soft, natural look. A new dewy freshness. Nothing about Hi-Fi says made up. Everything says you're beautiful. In 9 natural shades. Hi-Fi Fluid Makeup by Max Factor.
Here's exciting news. Lashful. Brand new from Max Factor. Much more than mere mascara. Actually makes your lashes thicker, longer, lovelier, as no ordinary mascara can. And it's refillable. From Max Factor, of course.
And now, from the Hollywood Palace, here is your host, America's musical ambassador of goodwill, celebrating his 50th anniversary in entertainment, the great Satchmo, Louis Armstrong!
It's nice to have you back with us once more.
Hello, Dolly. This is Louis, Dolly. Mighty glad to have you back where you belong. You looking swell, Dolly. I can tell, Dolly. You keep blowing, you're still growing, you're still going strong. I feel the room swaying and the band's playing one of our favorite tunes, Rowan and Martin. Yeah, boy. Take a rap, fellas. Let an empty level, fellas. I doubt they never go for free. I doubt you ever go for free.
You know something, Satch?
What is it, Daddy?
Welcome back from East Berlin.
Oh,
say, tell me something. Did they understand your music over there?
Did they understand it? You know, Jimmy, music is a language everybody understands.
You know something? I hear Berlitz wants to rent your lips. You know, Louis, I have a message for you.
Yeah.
From, for you.
Yeah. I'm with you.
You know, I have a message for you from your fellow actors.
Okay.
It says, on behalf of 15,000 members of the Screen Actors Guild, we extend our warmest congratulations and felicitations on the occasion of the 50th anniversary of your entry into show business. May you continue for another 50 years to be our ambassador of goodwill to the rest of the world. George Chandler, Screen Actors Guild.
let's start the show with the wildest bunch of jumping beans that ever come over the border. The famous ballet Folklorico of Mexico.
Go from one deodorant to another only to have them fall down on the job? Well, here's the one you've been looking for. Manpower, the aerosol deodorant with the power to do the job start to finish. Watch. First, Manpower has penetration power. Its powered mist gets through. Second, Manpower has covering power. Dries fast, never sticky. And third, Manpower has staying power. That's 24-hour staying power. Get Manpower, the aerosol deodorant with the power to do the job start to finish.
Well, if it's that good, why don't we get the family size? Then we can all use it.
Get Manpower by the makers of Old Spice. Regular size or new family size. Manpower.
Now, I'd like to introduce the entertainer that I think is the world's greatest, the one and only Jimmy Durante.
Say, I'm Jimmy, that well-dressed man. I'm a better man than Dapper Dan. You can have your suits for 150. Take a look at mine for 20. Don't I look nifty? Just feel that piece of gabardine. Don't touch the goods. Why, when I taught Rex Harrison how to dress to kill, he didn't know his Worcester from his English swill. Say, I'm Jimmy, that well-dressed man. Now tonight if you can. Say goodnight if you can. Now what a day, what a day, what a day. Why the bells are ringing, the birds are singing. What a day, what a day, what a day. Why the flowers are blooming. How do you do? Mitch, you don't know what you're doing. Don't know what you're doing. Don't know what you're doing. Say what a day, what a day, what a day. Why the belts are ringing, the bourbon. Turn around, let everybody see the shine on the back of the pants. Come here, I want to talk to you a minute. You see the band plays without you, right?
Right.
Don't show up tomorrow night, huh? Belts are ringing, the birds say, what a day, what a day. He don't know how to play an instrument, so they gave him a stick. You know, folks, Mitch, he gave me the telephone number of a blind date. So, picking up the receiver, I said, hello. She says, hello, come right over. When I got there, she took one look at my nose and said, you sure must have hurried. You forgot to hang up the phone. Let me hear that band. Mitch, I'd like to play a solo on the piano without the accompaniment of the aggravation you have beneath you. Let Armstrong try to do that with his trumpet. Follow me, I don't follow you. We've got a horse and a half of the hot potato, and now you think you're to work. Saying then you fix your bowl. Now you stop to turn, but then you turn, but then you turn, but then you turn for a finish. Do this. A fake, but it's great. Let me hear that band. Blow it up. Hit it.
How can a guy remember his lines? Everybody does what they want, no management. Now I know what a milkshake goes through.
We got a cold in the head from the hot potato, and now you put your toe, say, and then you fix your bowl. Now you start the cold. Say again, you for a finish, do this again. You take time in every one of you. Take time. Take time. Take time, and I'm telling you. Take it easy, take it easy. We got a date tonight. Again, you turn. Again, keep turning. For a finish to this. Keep turning, I'm telling you. Keep turning. Wait a minute. What's the matter with you girls? It seems since you got an offer from the Hollywood Palace, you've been dogging the joint. Now keep turning, you hear? Every one of them. I forgot the line. What do you want? You don't know who's out front. Why, the guy that don't look like a boss and looks like a bum, that's the boss. I know it was in your fault. You can make as many mistakes as you want.
Wait a minute, stop the music, stop the music. I saw you was getting tired, so I stopped the music.
For a finish of this, I'm late, but it's great. Get off, get off.
Louis, yeah, I want to congratulate you on the perspicuous and suspicious occasion.
Okay, there. I dig it.
You can't stick to Durante.
Thank you, Jimmy. You know, a little later, you and I are going to do a duet together.
Yeah, we're going to sing a little close harmony.
Yes,
but with my nose, I want you to remember one thing.
What's that?
We can't get too close together.
You know,
ready for a break? Try something different for a change. Turn to Salem Filter Cigarettes. For a taste that's springtime fresh.
Turn to Salem, you'll enjoy that springtime taste. Turn to Salem, for a taste that's springtime fresh.
Discover Salem, the largest selling menthol cigarette in America. Salem brings you rich tobacco taste, menthol soft flavor. Salem flavor refreshes your taste.
Try something different for a change. Turn to Salem, you'll enjoy that springtime taste. Turn to Salem, for a taste that's springtime fresh.
Our next star is Diahann Carroll, who can sing any kind of music. But tonight, for Pops, she's gonna sing the blues. And here she is, folks.
The songs I'm going to sing now have evolved from the folk blues, which is truly American and has a great influence on all American music. Since Mr. Louis Armstrong has taken the blues all over the world, I'd like to dedicate this to him.
of town. I'm gonna move way out on the outskirts of town. Well, my man don't want nobody who's always hanging around. He took away my icebox, gonna buy me a Frigidaire. Said that he don't want no iceman, always hanging round over here. I'm gonna move way out on the outskirts of town. Well, my man don't want no. Who's always hanging round? I love you, Porgy. Don't let him take me. Don't let him handle me. He'll drive me mad. If you can keep me, I want to stay here with you forever, and I'd be glad. Someday I know he's coming back to call me. He's gonna handle me and hold me so. It's gonna be like dying, Porgy, deep. But when he calls, I know I have to go. Oh, I love you, Porgy. Don't let him take me. Don't let him handle me. He'll drive me mad. If you could only keep me, I want to stay here with you forever. I've got mama.
Of a millionaire, spending my money, I did not care. Like Bessie Smith, I kept my friends out for a good time. We had bootleg liquor, champagne, wine. Then I began to fall so low. Didn't have a dime, a friend, no place to go. If I ever get my hands on a dollar again, I'm gonna squeeze it and hold on to it and look at it till the eagle grins. Nobody wants you, let me tell ya. When you are down and out, yeah. In my pocket, not one penny. Where were all my friends? I haven't any. Ever get back on my feet again. Oh, everybody will wanna be my long lost friend. Well, it's mighty strange, without a doubt. How nobody wants ya, and then nobody will have ya. Nobody loves ya, nobody needs ya when you're down and out.
very special message for you.
What, another one? Get more messages than Garcia.
Well, this one is sure to tell you how all the musicians in America feel about you. It says, mere words cannot express the feelings and the respect of the American Federation of Musicians, not only for your illustrious career, but as goodwill ambassador for the entire United States. And it's signed John V. Trancatella, the American Federation of Musicians.
We've got lots more show in the Hollywood Palace, folks. So don't go away. We'll be right back. This is Lewis back in their Hollywood Palace. Now you're going to see three members of the Ballet Folklorico in their famous deer dance. I've been all over the world, and this is one of the greatest things I've ever seen, the deer dance. Thank you.
Is compact, it's fast, and like her car, the lady's hair dryer is compact and fast. It's the new Lady Sunbeam Jet Set hair dryer with the self-storing hose. It's so fast that it actually dries average hair in just 22 minutes. Most dryers move air slowly, like this, but the Lady Sunbeam Jet Set hair dryer moves more air faster to dry your hair quickly without uncomfortable heat. Just select any one of four comfortable temperatures, then relax. Or if you're busy, Lady Sunbeam's 12-foot cord lets you move about freely. And in just 22 minutes, you'll have gone from this to this. To keep your hair looking its loveliest, get the one hair dryer that's fast, compact, and with self-storing hose. The new Lady Sunbeam Jet Set hair dryer, available in two distinctive styles by Sunbeam.
I'm going to enjoy the next few moments just as much as you, because here are two of my favorite guys, Rowan and Martin.
Here we are, standing out here just around the corner from Hollywood and Vine in front of the Hollywood Palace. As you know, Hollywood, California, one of the meccas. Tourists from all around the world, and we have a lot of visitors in the city currently. We're going to talk to some of them as they walk past the building. This gentleman here looks obviously as if he must be a visitor. He has, sir? Well, you certainly have the stamp of tourist written all over you. You're a visitor to our fair city, are you, sir?
You knew I was from out of town, huh?
Well, I could... I thought perhaps you might be. You seem to have all the accoutrements.
Well, I've been taking something for it.
You seem to have quite a bit of the equipment.
Oh, yes, that's for the binoculars and the camera, you know, like take some pictures of
case
the
to carry
movie
all the,
stars.
All the, have you came out to see some movie
came
stars?
Came out to see some stars.
A lot of people are always looking for stars.
Yeah.
Right
there. Ellie, I just hope I see Lyle Talbot or something.
You never know who you're going to run into.
Oh, wow.
You know, they say sooner or later everybody will pass the corner of Hollywood and Vine.
Is that right?
I'm sure that you're going to see. You don't mind chatting with us for a
minute
or two. You see, we're on television.
Oh, you're kidding.
Yeah,
oh, this
right.
is a big thrill for me.
We have a camera located across the street over there.
Oh, fine.
A little lens that zooms right in. They can see.
Say hello to the folks in Battle Creek, Michigan.
Is that where you're from, sir?
Yep, that's the old cereal capital of the world, you know.
Battle Creek, Michigan. Yes, are you?
Shoot them right out of guns.
are you in the cereal business yourself, sir?
No. I'm just out here a tourist. I'm a doctor.
You're a doctor.
A DM.
MD?
MD, MD.
Doctor, it must be nice to get away from your practice.
Oh, I'd like to get out here and see some stars, you
know. Yes, sir. What sort of doctor are you?
I'm a good doctor.
No. Are you a GP?
No, I've been in this country all my life.
No. You have a specialty? Are you an obstetrics?
No, we're down next to the elevator, actually.
I'm trying to find out your medical specialty, doctor.
Oh, I'm a surgeon.
Surgeon. You're a general surgeon, aren't
general
you?
Surgeon. General surgeon. That's the joke we have down there.
Down where, sir?
Say general surgeon.
Oh, I see. Well, that means as general surgeon, you operate on anything from head to foot.
Just point it out.
Yeah. Well, of course, that's a very difficult job, and you deserve a vacation out here in the beautiful sunshine.
You,
of course,
you.
We realize you don't operate alone, do you?
No, we like to have a patient there. You go cutting right through the sheets, otherwise.
You misunderstand. I mean, you have...
Get a nasty note from the laundry.
No, I mean, you have to really know your job very thoroughly.
Oh, you certainly are.
Yes, sir. Once a surgeon takes that knife in his hand...
Look out.
Yeah, well, you don't want to make any mistakes.
Why not? Who's going to know? We all wear those little masks when we know who did it.
We all know those masks are to keep you sterile. There are several questions, doctor, that I want to ask as a representative of the medical profession.
I didn't know that.
I would imagine from the... if you just listen carefully now. I want you to answer several questions
we've been asking
all of our tourist friends visiting.
Fine.
First of all, you realize there must be thousands of young men around the country.
Well, there must be. I see them on the streets all the time.
Watching our program tonight. Oh. Now, I'll bet you that some of these young men are interested in medicine.
Well, good. I'll tell you what, we could sure use them. You know, doctoring is a good thing.
Well, the country needs more doctors.
We need more country doctors.
Yeah, well, all sorts of doctors. But, of course, you just don't get to be a surgeon.
No, sir, you've got to study.
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 Study a long time. Yes, sir. How did you make out in school yourself, sir?
Well, I graduated number one in a class of over 346.
300?
Yes, sir.
Huh?
Yeah, well, yes, you could say that. Mm-hmm. Actually, when I was the valedictorian.
The valedictorian?
That's the one. That's the one.
You were the valedictorian of your class.
I certainly could.
You made that speech on graduation day.
I certainly am.
What did you tell them?
Well, I just gave them a little pep talk and gave them my motto. And
your
just,
motto?
Yes, uh-huh.
You have a motto.
Oh, I guess so.
Is this something, something you've had all your life?
Oh, since I was 13 years old. Oh, yes. I feel that success and a good motto go hand in hand.
Well, I imagine it does. I know so many famous
motto.
Men seem to have had a motto that they live
Benjamin
by. Well,
Franklin.
Very quickly, Doctor, would you mind passing your motto on to our television audience? It might help some of these young fellows.
Well, I'd be more than happy. If they could write it down, it would even
well,
you know,
sure, if
be
they
better.
Want to, they'll do that.
All right.
Right
the motto that has helped me through life and through school, and it goes, over the fence and through the woods. How many times have we seen it? Sometimes it's round, and sometimes it comes back. We must feel in our hearts that all of us that have ever, and the footprints in the sands of time, knowing these things, and maybe we could grab a handful someday. What'd you ask me?
Doctor, and it's been a pleasure chatting with you. I'm sure there was something in there for almost everybody.
I hope so.
And we want to thank you for appearing on our show. Would you say good night, please?
Good night. Thank you very much.
Wonderful, fellas. You two are the most.
Well, thanks very much, Lou. You know, we're happy to be on this particular show to help you celebrate your 50 years and 50th anniversary.
50 years. Can you imagine that? It'd be funny after 50 years in show business if his throat clears up.
Louis, I have a message for you from your fellow entertainers, including Dick and myself, and I'd like to read it to you. Your fellow artists extend greetings and our compliments on this commemorative occasion. You personify the evolution of good entertainment for the past 50 years. We are especially proud of the magnificent image of America that you have presented throughout the world, and this wire is signed by Claude L. McHugh, American Federation of Television and Radio Artists. Louis, congratulations.
Yeah.
Fellas, I'm flabbergasted.
Oh, is that what you Just don't forget to pay your union dues.
Come on.
Congratulations.
Well, we'll be back in just a minute.
Now here's Helen O'Connell.
Hi. Tonight I'm going to take Rowan and Martin's picture with my Polaroid color pack camera. Smile nice now, fellas. Thank you. We'll have our color picture in just about a minute. You know, if you're like most folks, you probably wanted to own a Polaroid camera, but maybe you thought it was too expensive. Well, that's not so anymore. Now, there's a whole line of Polaroid color pack cameras starting with this model that costs just under $60, right on up to this one, the same model I'm using tonight, and the finest camera Polaroid has ever made. They all make great color shots in 60 seconds, and black and white in 10. Now, if this picture's half as good as most of the Polaroid pictures I've taken, I know it'll be terrific. Let's see. Uh-huh. You see? Just wonderful. Polaroid camera prices now start at less than $60.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Edward G. Robinson.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Like everyone else in the Hollywood Palace this evening, I'm here to pay my respects to Louis Armstrong. I put down a few words about this unique and irreplaceable man, and I should like to read them to you. I'm proud to be a member of the entertainment profession because Louis Armstrong is a member of it. I'm proud to be an American because Louis Armstrong is an American. When Louis returned from East Berlin and they asked him how the people behind the Iron Curtain received his music, he said, "Notes are all the same everywhere. When a good old note is blown, all the cats dig it." There's wisdom in what Louis said, even more perhaps than he realizes. The words were his own, and in his own vernacular. But what he really said was that for the Louis Armstrong brand of pure, unadulterated human talent, there are no barriers. There are no walls. When Louis blows his trumpet, all the walls come down. The walls that the communists build in Europe and the walls in our hearts at home. As Louis said, all the cats dig it. I'm sure that behind the Iron Curtain, they dug Louis for what he really is. A true picture of what America stands for, is striving for all the world to see. I wish we had more ambassadors like Louis Armstrong. As for how Louis is regarded in our own country, I would like to read from the Congressional Record a statement by a senator of the United States. "Mr. President, Louis Satchmo Armstrong, who has been touring the world winning friends for the United States for the past 15 years, scored another victory recently. With his gravel voice, his natural gift for human relations, and most importantly, with his golden jazz trumpet, he was the first American entertainer to appear in East Germany. He played music which has been decried by the communists for years as being degenerate. And he was triumphant. Even the communist daily newspaper was forced to review Louis' performance on page one and to admit that it was an outstanding success. This is the work of an entertainer with so much humanity and so much talent that he has enthralled peoples of scores of nations and all races throughout the world. He has been called Ambassador Satch for his work in making the vitality of the American spirit in folk jazz music known throughout the world, both through the State Department's Culture Exchange Program and his own tours. He deserves the gratitude and the thanks of the U.S. government and all Americans. And I feel that Louis Armstrong, a son of New Orleans who delivered coal and played at funerals to get his start 50 years ago, should certainly be very seriously considered for a Presidential Medal of Freedom for his services to his country. And I have suggested it to the president." Signed, Jacob K. Javits, United States Senator from New York. And now, for the most vivid picture of Louis Armstrong, I give you the great Satchmo himself.
Louis, I should like to read to you a telegram that we've received, addressed to you. Very imposing, isn't it? "Louis Armstrong, may I join you and your many friends gathered in Hollywood, as well as the countless admirers who are thinking of you this day as you observe your 50th anniversary as an entertainer. Few men have contributed so generously and brilliantly to the entertainment and delight both of your own countrymen and of people throughout the world. Your voice and your trumpet are emblems of the universal power of music and of human talent. With all good wishes, Lyndon Baines Johnson.
Thank you, Mr. Robinson. And thank you, Mr. President. Now, this one's for you. Saints marching in, when the saints go marching in, by want to be in that number, yes, when the saints go marching in. Lead away, boy. As a jackknife, as Mack he did, and he keeps it out of sight. When the shark bites with his teeth, dear, scarlet billows start to spread. Fancy gloves, though, as Mack he did. So there's not a trace of red. Oh, on the sidewalk Sunday morning lies a body oozing life. Someone sneaking around the corner. Is that someone Mack tonight? Yes, from a tugboat by the river, baby. A cement bag drooping down, and the cement's for the weight, dear, that you make him back in town. Yes, Louis Miller disappeared, dear, after drawing out all his cash. And Mack he spends like a sailor. Did our boy do something rash? Suki Tatri, Jenny Divo, Lottie Lanyers, and Lucy Brown. Yes, the line bounds on the right, dear. Now that Mack is back in town. very ill when I found you. The moon stood still on Blueberry Hill, and it wasn't until my dream come true. Though when the willows play love's sweet melody, all of those vows were made were never to be. Though we were vowed, you part of me still. Oh, you were my thrill.
Panatella Extra, the new mild modern cigar for every smoker. The Panatella Extra is long and slim in the modern manner. Handsome. Never has the Panatella been in better shape. Extra taste, great taste. Fine, naturally light tobaccos blended the Muriel mild way. Result? Extra pleasure in every puff of every Muriel Panatella Extra. Treat yourself to a great new 10-cent cigar and join the crowd that smokes mild. Muriel Mild.
Why don't you pick one up and smoke it sometime? A Muriel Panatella Extra.
You know something, Satch?
What's that, Daddy?
I've been around a few years myself.
Yeah.
You know, between your trumpet and my nose, we've blown 100 years together.
Well, I tell you what, let's start blowing the second 100 years.
Right
now, huh?
Let me hear.
Okay.
Old man time.
That's it, Jimmy. Swing out there.
He's so mean.
He's so mean.
Meanest man.
Oh, meanest man.
You ever see.
Oh, yes.
He gives you youth, then he steals it away. Yeah. He takes your nights, curly hair, turns it gray.
Makes you rich.
Yeah.
Makes you poor. He's a dog.
He's a dog.
All your dreams and your schemes ain't worth the dime.
So have a good time every day.
That's right.
Cause we'll never, never get away from old man time. Old man time.
Old man time.
That boogaboo. Every year,
every year,
he changes you.
He bends your back, dims your eyes, you see less.
You quake and shake when he's true. You're a mess.
And makes you fret.
Yeah.
That's not all.
Yeah.
Plays tricks on us all.
Yeah.
Every year.
Yeah.
No sense in rhyme.
So have a good time every day.
Right.
Cause we'll never, never get away.
Swing it, Jimmy.
From old man,
old man time. But there's one thing he can't change. Love that's true stays the same. It goes on and on in every line. You know, Satch, it's been a pleasure being here with you tonight. Believe me.
Okay, thanks, Jimmy. Everybody been so nice in all these messages. I don't know how to really express my appreciation.
That's easy. Huh? Just stick around another 50 years.
Yeah. Wow!
Has been brought to you by Consolidated Cigar Corporation, makers of Muriel, the light cigar in six shapes for thoughtful modern smokers, and by Polaroid, makers of the new economy model of a Polaroid color pack camera for color pictures in 60 seconds, black and white in 10. This is Dick Tufel speaking. The Ballet Folklorico of Mexico, directed and choreographed by Emilia Hernandez, appeared by arrangement of Pure Rock Attractions. Don't forget next week at the Hollywood Palace, the Back Porch Majority, Gene Bayless, Jack Cole, Gene Fenn, the Gima Brothers, Mickey Rooney and Bobby Van, Diane Shelton, Yonelli, and your host, Steve Lawrence.